She turned to Zaldan and asked, "Did you know that the Taliban have threatened this innocent girl?" They had no idea of what this woman was talking about, but a quick Google search uncovered a new video that had emerged that morning of a Taliban issuing a threat against Shahid Begum, a 33-year-old social worker and activist, and against Malala. Initially, they didn't take the threat seriously, but family and friends from across the country began calling them to issue stern warnings for Malala to keep her head down. The day everything changed was Tuesday, 9th of October, 2012. Malala was just finishing her exams for the school year, and she and her friends were hanging out around the school, chatting about how they went before getting the late bus home. When the bus arrived, all the kids ran down the steps and piled in. The other girls all covered their faces before leaving the buildings, whereas Malala wore a scarf over her head, but never over her face. All the girls were singing and chatting. Since they were in the back of the bus, they couldn't see what was going on in the road in front of them. A young bearded man stepped out and waved the bus down. "Is this the Kushal school bus?" he asked the driver. When the man asked for information about some of the school students, the driver basically told him to buzz off and go to the school office if he had more questions. As they spoke, a second young man dressed in white approached the back of the van. "Look, it's one of those journalists coming to ask for an interview," said of one of Malala's friends. But this young man didn't look like a journalist. He swung himself into the van and leaned in. "Who is Malala?" he demanded. No one spoke a word, but a few girls glanced over to see that Malala was the only one without her face covered. That's when he lifted up a black Colt 45 pistol. Some of the girls screamed. The gunman fired three shots, one after another. The first went through Malala's left eye socket. She slumped forward and fell into her friend's lap. The second and third shots hit the girls on either side of her. The bus driver sped toward the hospital. Boldness beats cowardice. A week after the shooting, after multiple rounds of major surgeries in three hospitals across two countries, Malala eventually woke up. She was in Birmingham, UK, thousands of miles away from home, with no idea where her family was and a tube in her neck to help her breathe. Malala was bold. She was speaking up for a basic right to go to school. She risked her comfort and safety to stand up for what she believed in and stand up for the 50,000 girls who were banned from going to school. The gunman was the opposite of bold. He was cowardly. He tried to shoot an innocent 15-year-old girl in cold blood just to keep her quiet. He thought if he killed Malala, he was serving his own cause. But it backfired. All the Taliban had done was make Malala's campaign global. Britain's former Prime Minister, Gordon Brown, started a movement called I Am Malala, with a global petition to demand that no child be denied schooling by 2015.